Our next speaker, Dr. Marta Giuli, presentation, spring lecture, approximation in the studies of nonlinear as electric properties of special confined solutions.
Problem. It is important to note that there are some exceptions which do not follow this rule, and one of these exceptions is carbon sulfide. The results of previous studies show that in the presence of carbonic oscillator potential used in order to model the effect of spatial confinement, the dipole moment and first hyperpolarizability of carbon sulfide increase when the strength of confinement becomes larger. So I wanted to investigate that problem using another approach, using supermolecular approximation. And I was mainly focused in this project on the analysis how orbital compression anisotropy affects linear and nonlinear properties of this system. So the first step was to distinguish the orbital compression effect among other factors which are included in supermolecular approximation. And in order to do that, I used helium atoms. They are chemically and electronically energetically polarizable, so they are quite suitable to model the effect of orbital compression. The next thing, topology of confinement cages. As I said, I was mainly interested in the analysis how the orbital compression anisotropy influences the studied properties. So I used different number of helium atoms in different orientation and different distances to carbon sulfide. And the computational procedure, all the calculations were performed within the topic clusters, the CSD-defined SSD method in connection with Daniel's augmented correlation consistent triple Z analysis set. During calculations, the experimental bond lengths of carbon sulfide were kept frozen, and to calculate the components of dipole moment polarizability and first hyperpolarizability, I used finite field approach. And the results. The main thing which we can observe here is that the anisotropy of orbital compression is quite strong, and it strongly influences static properties. As we can see, different changes in the static properties for different models. When the strength of confinement is not very large, it's between 2 and 3 angstrom, those are the distances between helium atoms and carbon sulfide, the changes in dipole moment polarizability and first hyperpolarizability are very small, but on the other hand, when the strength of confinement becomes larger, the changes are quite significant and very non-monotonic. The dominant effect is the increase of the studied properties with increasing confinement strength. The only exception is model with two helium atoms placed perpendicularly to the molecular axis of carbon sulfide. For this model, we can observe the decrease of the static properties followed by a small increase. So the main conclusion here is that the static properties, dipole moment polarizability and first hyperpolarizability, strongly depend on the topology of confinement environments. And further studies, the next step will be to perform calculations for other molecules in order to see if we can observe some kind of pattern in the behavior of linear and nonlinear optical properties of molecules embedded in helium confined environments. And I think this can be very helpful in studies of real chemical situations, like for example molecules trapped inside helium nanoorbits. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. Don't do questions, but thank you again.